In this video lecture, I will explain to you about pseudo-random binary sequence generator. This is the logic diagram of 4-bit pseudo-random binary sequence generator. Here, it consists of D type of flip-flops and we are handling 4 number of binary bits. So, we are going to use 4 number of flip-flops like A flip-flop, B flip-flop, C flip-flop and D flip-flop. Here, there is a suitable feedback from the C flip-flop and D flip-flop to first flip-flop A via exclusive OR gate. And by using this feedback, we are going to generate pseudo-random binary sequence. The first flip-flop QA output is connected to the input of the second flip-flop. Second flip-flop output is connected to the third flip-flop input. And third flip-flop output is connected to the fourth flip-flop input. Here, to generate the input of the first flip-flop DA, we are going to use the bits output of C flip-flop and output of D flip-flop. They are QC and QD. These QC and QD are connected to the exclusive OR gate, and regarding this exclusive OR gate, truth table is here. When the bits are 00, the output is going to be 0. When the bits are 01, output is going to be 1, and so on. Here, initially, the outputs of the 4-bit pseudo-random binary sequence generator QD, QC, QB, QA are initially considered as 0, 0, 0, 1. So, these are the bits before clock pulse. So, after triggering the clock pulse, here, this generator is going to be starts working. So, after giving the first clock pulse, the QA, the first flip-flop output, is going to be decided by the bits of previous outputs of QC and QD. When these bits are 00, these bits are connected to the exclusive OR gate. It will generate 0 to DA. When DA equal to 0, definitely the QA will be 0. Already we know the D flip-flop truth table. When the D input is 0, that output is going to be 0. When the D input is 1, that output is going to be 1. By using this truth table, here DA equal to 0 means QA will be 0. So here QA is going to be 0. And QB, after clock pulse, QB we may generate by using the previous output of QA. So, this QA is connected to the input of the B flip-flop DB. So, DB equal to 1 means the QB is also 1. Based on this pattern, QC after clock pulse from the previous output of QB, this is going to be 0. Then, after clock pulse, the QD bit is going to depends on previous bit of QC, that will be 0. So, in this similar fashion, after applying second clock pulse, the QA bit is going to be decided by the previous outputs of QC and QD. Again, here 00 means this QA will be 0. And QB, QC, QD are previous bits of QA, QB, QC. So, here I am writing 0, 1, 0. So, next here, after applying the third clock pulse, to generate the QA, the previous bits QC, QD are 0, 1. When these bits are 0, 1, for the exclusive OR gate, they generate output as 1. So, here the QA will become 1. Next, here, based on the previous QA, the QB will be 0. Here 0, based on this, here 1. In this similar fashion, we may get all the binary states. So here, by applying clock pulses here, these all are the different binary states we may obtain. So after applying 14th clock pulse here, the QA bit is going to be depends on QC, QD 1 and 1. This will give QA as 0, and QB, QC, QD are going to depends on previous bits of QA, QB and QC. In this manner, we may generate different types of binary sequences by using this pseudo-random binary sequence generator. The applications of this pseudo-random sequence generator, the first one is, by using this generator, we may test the digital circuits. The second one, by using this sequence generator, we may encrypt the digital data so that unauthorized persons may not be able to read the data. The third one, this circuit can be connected to digital to analog converter so that it can generate random noise, can be used to test the audio system. This completes the explanation of pseudo-random binary sequence generator.